Okay, now let me start my presentation. My presentation title is Components Reconsidered. Hello everyone again. I'm now very nervous right now as my last English presentation was 2 years ago at Cake Fest held in Tokyo. I'll try my best to warm up the Cake Fest as a presenter. I'd appreciate your comment in either chat or Slack to make the Cake Fest a blast. First of all, let me briefly introduce myself. My name is Sho Ito. I'm Japanese and live in Tokyo. I'm active on Twitter and GitHub, and my username is itosho. I like basketball and soccer, and I often watch NBA games and Premier League games. I've recently got a dog, and he may bark during my presentation, but please bear with me. And I specialize in backend development and have contributed to Cake PHP several times. I've developed a Cake PHP plugin called EasyQuery that can easily perform bulk insert and upsert. It's a useful plugin, so please give it a try. And I work as a CTO at Connect Incorporated. We've been using Cake PHP, our backend system, since our company was founded. So I'm so grateful to the organizers for providing me with an opportunity to give a talk at Cake Fest today. Next, about my company. Let me give you an overview of our company, Connector. Our mission is creating services that people cannot live without. Mamari is the main service we are operating with a mission to support mothers each step. Specifically, the service is offered through a smartphone app. Mamari has three key features. The first one is a Q&A community. It provides a warm community where mothers can talk to each other about their worries and experiences about childbearing and child care. The second feature is a media website that delivers useful articles every day to mothers. The third feature is Mamari Premium, which is a kind of monthly subscription service. Mamari is now used by one-third of mothers in Japan. It has also been awarded as the number one app for mothers. All right, now I'd like to get into the topic of the presentation. To start with, have you ever used components? I guess many of you have used components before. Then, when and in what case do you use components? I think you may have a variety of opinions about this. So during my presentation, I'd like to embark on a journey to seek better software through reconsideration of components. I have three main topics in the presentation. First, I would like to go over and remind you what components are. And then I'll introduce a general use case and one other case I often use. After that, I'll show you how the two cases can be solved by using different approaches. Specifically, I will talk about approaches using traits and dependency injections. Finally, I'll show my opinion on when you should use components and when you should not. Code examples will show up on some slides. Those examples are in the form of excerpts, so please refer to this GitHub repository. If you won't see the entire code or have a hard time seeing them here on the screen, let's see. I just posted this URL to the CakeFest channel on Slack. So, and the code you'll show today is implemented in PHP 8.0 and CakePHP 4.2. All right, let's move on the first topic. What are components? Many of you may know that on the official website, components are defined as packages of the logic that are shared between controller classes. And there are some core components in the framework of CakePHP, such as flash components that can perform one-time message notification, and request handler components that can obtain and pass HTTP requests. By the way, OAuth component and security component are currently deprecated. So it is recommended to use official authentication and authorization plugins for OAuth components. And use form protection component or HTTP enforcer middleware instead of security component. This slide shows the basic usage of components. Here, I'm using a PageNetter component as an example. Please pay attention to boxes marked in red. First, you can use the PageNetter component by invoking the load component method inside the initialize method of the controller. Then you can smoothly process pagination by using the method defined in the component called paginate here. Now that we've reviewed components, let's look into the general use case. When to create your own component class? It is a case where a component is used as a package of so-called shared logic. Specifically, if there is a logic used by many controllers, create a component and move that logic to the components. Doing so will prevent fat controllers and allow code reuse. And you can run a unit testing focused on that logic by separating the logic from controllers. Let's take a look at the code to see how it actually looks like. First, the code on the left does not use a component. And the code on the right has the logic of this red box moved to a component. The original logic is extracted as the mass component and defined as the do complex operation method. This is the same method as a simple example on the official website. But actually it can extract a more complicated logic. Then the controller loads the mass component and calls the do complex operation method here. And this is how the mass component testing looks like. To test the component, first create a component registry object with the setup method. And then give that component registry as an argument when initializing the mass component object. Then what is left to write is a test case for the do complex operation method. From this example, you can learn that by extracting into a component, the controller is cleaner and the code can be reused. Now let's look at the case I often use. This is a case where a component is used as a service-like class. By the way, the term service class is so ambiguous. But here it means a procedure class with domain knowledge of how to suppress the expansion and to simplify the responsibilities of the model layer. Specifically, imagine when you want to call an external API from a controller. Here, a code example uses an API called Kita API, which is a Japanese weblog service for engineers. It's similar to dev.to. So in the case of calling an external API, first create a HTTP client and then create a component. This component is a wrapper for the HTTP client, and the HTTP client and the controller are loosely coupled. This allows you to remove the business logic from the controller. While making the client and the controller independent, eases unit testing. Okay, now let's look at the code. This is the Kita API client. The implementation is simple. It first generates an HTTP client and requests the Kita API. Here, guest title by ID is defined as a method that returns the title of an article for specified ID. On the right is the test code. By mocking the HTTP client, we are testing without actually requesting the API. Next. The following is a component and a controller codes. The component is named Article API components. This is because from the controller's point of view, you don't need to know the Kita API information. You just need to know how to get the information about the article. Since the component is actually a wrapper for Kita API clients, we also define a method called getTitleByID. In controller, it is okay if you can call the getTitleByID methods defined in the component. The test code looks like this. As previously, the component is tested by mocking the Kita API client. The controller test is a mock-up the Article API component class. The unit testing is conducted by using Event Manager and by injecting the mockup into controller initialize. This is a case where component is used like a service-like class. So now let's shift gears. Up till now, I've shared with you two use cases of component. Now let's rethink the use case of a shared logic package. Again, the motivation for the usage is to clean the controller code and reuse it. And by this, the controller's behavior can be expanded in horizontal direction. Now, when you hear horizontal, does it remind you of something with a similar concept? Yes, it's traits. So let's say if we can do something similar to what we did using a component as a shared logic package with traits. I guess many of you know what traits are, let's review. Traits are language level mechanism for reusing code in single inheritance languages such as PHP. It is an addition to traditional inheritance and enables horizontal composition of behavior. They look and feel exactly like the component in the use case of a package of shared logic. By the way, a trait is similar to a class, but it is not possible to instantiate a trait on its own, as shown in the figure. Now let's rewrite the previous code using a trait. The code on the upper left describes a trait. Simply create a trait with the name masTrait and define the doComplex operation method. The lower left shows the test code for the trait as I mentioned earlier. Traits cannot be instantiated. Traits cannot be instantiated. So use it in one of the following ways. The first one is to use the trait in your test class directory. The second one is to use an anonymous class. Or the last one is to call the getMockForTrait method to run a unit testing. The getMockForTrait method returns the trait mock object given masTrait as an argument. This code example uses the getMockForTrait method. And on the right is the controller code. After making masTrait available in the use statement, the doComplex operation method is called. Yes, we could do the same with traits. Now let's rethink the service-like class use case. The motivation for this to remove the business logic from the controller. And the main purpose is to make a loose coupling between the HTTP client and the controller. Once again, I ask you a similar question. When you hear the word loose coupling, doesn't it remind you of something similar? Yes, it's DI, dependency injection. So let's see if we can do something similar to what we did using a component as a service-like class with DI. Like we did previously, let's review DI and the DI container first. In short, DI is a technique for changing code from being tightly coupled to becoming loosely coupled. Specifically, by injecting an object from the outside, the dependency between modules is seen. DI makes testing and managing our software easier. The point is to depend on abstractions, not on conclusions, as shown in the figure. By the way, the DI container is like a box that manages DI object in one place. In CakePHP, DI container can be officially used from version 4.2. Now let's rewrite the previous code using DI. Create an article API interface with the getTitleByID method defined as an abstract method. Then modify the Kita API client so that the interface is implemented. Except for the implementation of the interface, this code is exactly the same as the previous one. Next, add them to the DI container in the services method of the application class. Specifically, specify article API interface as the first argument of the add method, and Kita API client as the second argument. In CakePHP, method injection is adopted instead of constructor injection. So specify article API interface as the argument of the action method of the controller. And when you call the getTitleByID method, the getTitleByID method of the Kita API client is called. Since the controller does not know that it is called Kita API, this example demonstrates making a loose coupling. Finally, it comes down to the controller's test. When using DI, you only need to replace the concrete class. So by using the mock service method, you can easily test the concrete class by changing concrete class from Kita API client to an anonymous class for testing. In this way, we were able to do the same things as before with components. We did it. Now we are getting into the last topic. From this point and based on the presentation so far, I'd like to discuss when to use components and when not. In my presentation today, I have introduced two use cases for components. One is a shared logic package and the other is a service-like class. And I showed you that the same things could be accomplished with traits for the shared logic package and with DI for the service-like class. So let's think about whether you should use component or trait. I think it is better to use traits for a horizontal shared logic. And since many use cases are horizontal shared logic, using traits is usually sufficient. Also, since components are a part of controllers, I don't think you should write business logic in components. If the do complex operation method mentioned earlier is closer to the business logic, you'd better move it to the model layer. And this is a bit of topic, but if you are working with a shared logic about requests and responses, it might be possible to replace it with middleware. Then, when should we use components? I prefer to use components for more three-dimensional shared logic. Three-dimensional logic isn't just a simple horizontal logic. It's about leveraging and being aware of CakePHP's lifecycle. For example, the before filter method defined in the components is different from and executed before the controller's before filter method. I hope you will find this example suitable. This example code tried to through a bad request exception if the request parameters are incorrect. This process is executed before the controller's action method is called. And this is difficult to achieve with traits. In addition to the before filter method, the component has callback methods such as startup method, before render method, shutdown method, and before redirect method, which can augment the request lifecycle. This is a figure of their characteristic. Y-axis represents inheritance. X-axis represents traits, and Z-axis represents components. Now, let's think about whether you should use components or DI. In my opinion, it is better to use DI for a service-like class that calls an external API such as a HTTP client. This is because DI allows for looser coupling between modules than the service locator pattern adopted in components. Of course, we'd better be careful about the overuse of DI, but I think DI is a technique that can reduce the complexity of our software. However, this doesn't mean denying components. Adopting the service locator pattern is very much in the CakePHP way. Especially since CakePHP 3, the disadvantage of the service locator pattern have been reduced by changing from the policy of creating a global registry to a local registry. This slide shows side-by-side test code for using and components. When using DI, you don't need to modify the controller test even if the external API changes. While when using components, you need to modify the component test because of dependencies. So far, I've recommended non-components approaches, but are components inferior to traits and DI? Of course not. So components have something that traits and DI don't. What is it? It's convention. As you know, CakePHP is a COC, convention over configuration framework. This is very effective in team development. In team development, code inconsistency may occur because of multiple different individual coding styles. By bringing in the convention, you can get a unified developer experience. Since component is a standard CakePHP feature and already has convention, you can benefit from it right from the start. On the other hand, traits and DI don't have convention, which makes it more challenging to maintain consistency. For example, you need to think from scratch about where to put traits or what to do with DI naming rules. Let's put it this way. If you have a very skilled team or a team that can afford efforts to keep code consistency, I'm sure you can use the best of traits and DI. My time is running out, so let's summarize. This is a table that summarizes when to use components or other approaches such as traits and DI. First of all, if you have a less professional team, my suggestion is to use components in every use case to emphasize discipline. On the other hand, if you have an experienced and skilled team, you may want to use traits as the horizontal shared logic and the components for the more three-dimensional shared logic. If you want to use a service like Glass that calls HTTP clients, it's better to use DI. And I've shared my ideas about components. You may have many other and different ideas, and my opinions may change depending on the direction of CakePHP evolutions in the future. I'll be grateful if you give me your feedback or opinions. So our journey to seek better software will continue. Thank you for your attention. So my English may not have been the easiest to understand, but I hope my presentation gives you new perspectives and insights in KQHP. If you have any questions or comments, I would love to discuss them. However, my verbal English may not be good enough to communicate. So please give me any questions and comments on Slack. And please continue to enjoy Cakefest. Thank you again.